That was Abba and Take a Chance on Me. Let's welcome back Pete and Melody.
Before you were doing that, you were doing cruise liners, weren't you, Melody? You were doing the P&O?
Yes, I worked on cruises for about 4 contracts, and I was really, really lucky. I got to do a world cruise, and I got to do the Med and the Baltics and Tenerife and all the Canaries. So I got to really see so much of the world, and I was very, very blessed and fortunate to get to do that so young.
Yeah, because you started performing at a very young age, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
It says age 5.
Yeah, I was 5. My mum, basically, she did amateur dramatics and took me along. And first I hated it because she took me when I was 3, but then when she took me back when I was 5. And I liked it a bit more then, so I continued doing it. And just kind of loved it so much that I didn't see myself doing anything else as a career apart from performing.
Yeah, because you're now based in Watford, is that correct, or Hertfordshire? The Abba.
I was born in Watford. Yeah. I lived in Watford for most of my younger days. Now I reside in Derby with Pete.
Oh, do you? Okay, no problem. That's all right. You fooled me because I thought you were based in Hertfordshire. Well, you are, aren't you, as such? But
My parents still live in Abbots. My brother lives in Watford, so all my family is still there. But I moved here not because of something, and it just went a bit wrong. So okay. I just ended up still staying here. We'd rather live down south.
It's too expensive. Too expensive living in Watford nowadays, isn't it?
Yeah.
And Pete, you grew up in a house full of music. Is your parents musical as well then?
There was a member of the family, an uncle or a great uncle. It was a great uncle, I think, who was a jazz guitarist. But it was more that my dad in particular and my mum were both massive fans of music, and it was everything from pop right through to quite sort of specialist blue note jazz albums. So I was lucky to grow up absorbing quite a lot of music. And then even at 5 years old, I think I remember Songs in the Key of Life by Stevie Wonder being my favourite album, which is, you know, it's got a lot of depth to it. So for a 5 year old, I thought I was doing quite well listening to that. From there, I've been lucky to have that foundation to go off and absorb many different styles of music and be exposed to music in all of its forms and many different genres.
Because you play the guitar.
I do. I also sing as well.
Yeah.
I cover both of those things.
That's quite good. Exactly as Bjorn did.
Yeah, multitasking.
Yeah.
We can't do it.
I can't play the guitar and I cannot sing, so please do not ask me to.
But at least you can do both of those things still together, not play and not sing together.
The two right, and people pay good money to ask me not to, I can promise you. So you've got two other members of the band as well. You've got Samantha, who plays Frida.
Yes.
And you have Chris, who plays Benny.
Yes,
they're not a couple as well, are they?
No, they're not. No.
It's uncanny that you two are a couple, although if I've got my history right, Agnetha wasn't actually married to Bjorn. She was married to Benny, is that correct?
No, she was married to Bjorn.
I got it wrong. I'm useless. So you paired up with the right people then?
Yeah, it's worked somehow.
It did work. So... getting away from the personal side, I won't delve any further into that. How do you see the longevity of ABBA? Why do you think they've been around and are still so popular now?
Well, when they brought out Mamma Mia, that definitely gave a new life to the music of ABBA, and obviously through the generations, little kids are singing Mamma Mia, you know. Mm. We do gigs and there's just a line of children in front of us sometimes. Everyone knows it now, you know, all the little kids up to older people. So it's definitely made a line across the generations.
Yeah, that must be great for you to play all across the generations, not the old people like myself. I'm over 50. We won't go no further than that. And I actually remember them, shall we say, when they were around. And then you've got, as you say, you've got probably the grandparents, you've got the parents and the children now coming to see you. So you've got like 3 generations. It's great, isn't it, really? There's not many groups who have managed to do that, really.
No, No, they've been very, very clever.
Yeah.
I would say.
Yeah, and probably they're the only band, really, to have hit it big from the Eurovision Song Contest.
Yeah, definitely. I think they're the best thing that's ever come out of it.
Well, you'd say that, wouldn't you, really?
Well, they did enter it the year before.
Did they?
With Ring Ring, but they didn't actually get through to the finals. So I guess they thought, we'll go back next year, and obviously took Waterloo, and that made it through to the finals.
Well, I mean, that was an iconic song. It really is. I've got some tracks of yours which I'm going to play during the show of you actually performing. I'm also going to be playing Agnetha's one of the tracks from a new album with it's called I Should Have Followed You Home with Garry Barlow. I'm going to be playing that in a little while, which is very different. And I think, you know, they've now brought her out of the sort of got her away from sort of the her habit life that she, you know, living on her own and all that business. She was always a bit of a problem. To Pete and Melody, your logo is appearing in a film during the summer, is that correct?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, are you going to tell everybody or shall I tell them?
You can tell them,
okay.
We don't mind.
The Sensations logo has been chosen to appear in the new Alan Partridge film, which I believe is out August?
Yeah, I think it is.
Good, yeah, he comes from Norwich. Obviously, there's just been a new museum open in Sweden, I believe it's in Stockholm. We spoke about sort of going over there. Have you actually ever been over to Sweden, not performing necessarily, but to have a look around Sweden?
I've been to Stockholm on many, many occasions. That was when I worked on the cruise ship. But Chris, who plays Benny in the show, he lived in Sweden for about 7 years, and his wife is actually Swedish. So He has loads to tell us about the Swedes. It's great.
Does he? So you, that's where you sort of get the best. Because you actually speak Swedish on stage. I'll get my teeth organised in a minute. That's a bit of a mouthful for me at this time of the day.
Chris does most of the Swedish speaking, especially when there are Swedes in the audience. Because the rest of us feel a little bit inadequate when there are real Swedes in the audience.
Well, I went to see, about 5 years ago, I went to see an Abba tribute band. I won't mention their name. And they sounded really good. And they actually, I thought they were speaking in Swedish. So when I got home, I Googled them. They actually come from Wales. But they fooled me completely. and about six of my friends who went along to see them. I was well, well fooled by that. So the current lineup has been going for, what, 5 years?
Yes.
Okay. And what makes you different from, shall we say, other ABBA tribute bands?
Well, apart from all the best. We have the Swedish man on our side to help us in Swedish situations, shall we say. That is a massive, massive help to us.
Mm.
Also, we like to keep a bit of comedy in the show because we feel that, you know, we're a tribute at the end of the day. We're, you know, dressing up as other people and doing their songs. So we feel that we need to keep a comedy aspect in the show because otherwise people might think we're taking it a bit too seriously.
Yeah, do you ever get anybody come up to you afterwards and say, that's not how I remember ABBA or vice versa? I assume you get a lot of people come up to you and sort of say, I really enjoyed that, otherwise you wouldn't carry on doing it. Have you, because everybody sees ABBA as different. I remember them in the very tight-fitting jumpsuits. From sort of Arrival onwards, I always remember that sort of era. I'm very much the later stages of ABBA.
Yeah.
I always remember that bit. But do you, I should imagine, is there a lot of costume changes during your act?
Yes, there's plenty of costume changes going on. There's lots of running on and off the stage for different people at different points to change their costumes. And I think, going back to your other question about people's memories of ABBA, One of the nicest compliments that we do get from time to time from various individuals is that is they say, well, because we all play live, and we're all sort of live performers and live singers and live musicians, and they'll say, wow, we really can't believe it just sounds just like the CD or just like we're listening to.